Hi, today we're going to find out what is Lightmix. This is a very convenient function, which was added to Corona. It allows you to change lighting and adjust it when rendering. That is, for example, you're rendering the final image and you can adjust lighting power, light intensity, and even color to turn some lamps off without changing this image. So let me tell you today how to set it. And we'll try to fix the light in the entire scene using the example of our scene in which we set up overcast lighting. Okay, so open the Corona render settings. I'll show you how to set light mix manually and how to set it automatically. Let's go to Render Elements tab, click Add. Let me delete all these unwanted elements. Click Add and add Light Mix. Here we don't need to change anything. We add the next render element, which we need. This is Light Select. In this field, we'll then add some light sources, create groups, and somehow combine them with each other. The first light source we add to light mix, we don't even select it, we just check the environment light box. We'll indicate which light to choose. Everything is already specified, and that's it. It will be the sky. In other words, with this tab, group, we'll adjust the power, the intensity of skylighting. Now let's add the sun. Type sun. Select our sun and click plus. We don't need to do anything else. Let me go to the light filters to make it easier to select lamps in the scene. Now let's split. We'll select this group of lamps. We'll group them now. Group, and again, group, we name it. Light, second floor. I specifically create a group in this way because you don't have to create a group in manual mode, but I create a group to show you how to do it automatically. We add these lamps and name them in the same way. Next, let's work with this group of lamps. Let's select the spotlights above. Here we'll turn these ones off. We'll not turn them on. So it's all right. Create a group again. Give it a name. Light, second floor, 2. We can create a separate group for these lamps. Now let's add the next layer, which is light select. Add it. But now we have the sun selected and it seems it got in the group. Let's ungroup and delete the sun from the group and copy again. Done. Now let's select these lamps, group, and name. Light second floor, 3. You can name the groups as you want, so you easily understand what and where it is. Let's also add these three lamps above the kitchen to the group. We'll name them light second floor kitchen. And downstairs, we also have lighting. All right, and the last room? Light first floor, too. I forgot to add it to the list, so let's add the kitchen group to light select. Now the lower floor, I'll just copy the name and add them. These lamps. Our son's been at it. You gotta be kidding me. And let's add these ones. We have them turned off, but we'll just turn them on to show how you can turn them on Lightmix. So let's delete all these other lamps. We don't create any groups for them. Just to do it faster. It seems I deleted the sun unsuccessfully. Well, okay. We'll put the sun again. Now I'll get the sun back. And we'll set it later. We just add it here. Now we go ahead and enable interactive render and see what we're getting. Look, now we go to Lightmix tab, and here we can do what I was talking about. We can turn the sky off or make it brighter. Not too bright, a bit duller. We can change color, make it warmer or colder. Let's make it colder. Next, we can make the sun sort of stronger. Let's do it like this, maybe a little warmer. Like this, quite a bit. All right, what's next? We can turn the light on or off, make it weaker. For example, change its temperature. Let it be like so. Here, I forgot to rename it, but it's not a big deal. We'll do it like this. And that's it. We can change any lighting in every way. And this will be changed right in our interactive render. Rendering will keep going and our picture will be rendered. So let's keep it this way and let's just turn this light off. And this upper light too. Now let me tell you about the settings of this lower menu. I'll tell you about the first button later. The save and load buttons allow setting this Lightmix in a certain manner. and, for example, download if you switch to another camera and you need to set Lightmix somehow in a different way. Then you can upload settings for another camera. The toggle all tab turns all lamps off, and otherwise, if we click it again, all lamps turn on. All 1.0 button is to make the intensity of all lamps 1. That's default. Or all white. Make all colors absolutely white. Scene tab allows uploading all these settings. Since we changed intensity, changed the light a little, right to the scene. That is, all lamps parameters will change. Let's try to do it. We'll click scene, then OK, and click yes. Settings uploaded. And look, now I can, for example, delete this light mix. But before it, let me save it just in case. If something goes wrong, we'll just save it so that I won't have to restore all these settings. Okay, now delete it and let's pause it and run interactive again and see what we've got. Okay, so in general, everything is as it should be. The only thing is that we didn't turn off these lamps, which were turned off, but the intensity, power, and even color changed. Let's turn them off, as we had. Okay, also these ones. And now I'm going to show you how to set light mix automatically. I created these groups for lamps for a reason. Here we click Setup Light Mix, select groups. It found 9 groups. Let it be so. Click Generate, and it automatically created this light mix structure by these groups. So what we've done manually has been done automatically now. You just need to group lamps, and Lightmix will do it for you. So this is what it looks like. In the same way, we can change it as we changed it before. But a special layer, Lightmix, appears here. If we go to the beauty layer, all of our changes will not respond, only in the Lightmix slot. And that's all. Thank you all. Use Lightmix. It's a very convenient tool to fix lighting a little in your render. Because when you're setting in the interactive, it's not always possible to see some lighting aspects. And it can be that when you see the final picture, you need to fix something. And it may be terribly sad if your Lightmix was not set up. That's why I think you should use it. Thanks for watching. See you later.